So spiritual awareness and how to actually achieve that. Now, most people accept that we're made up of mind, body and spirit. But for the most part, when what I realized in my own life was that my mind was really big, was like a bit out of control, if I'm honest. My body seemed to be aligned with my mind, so a bit big, bit out of control. But my spiritual part of me was what I call very tiny. I was very like, almost if there was a switch, it was sort of switched off. I was very unaware of it. Now, I've learned many things in the last 20 years that I could share with you, but I wanted to share just two things today that you could do. Perhaps if you're a beginner, this is a great place to start. If you're much more advanced and you've already reached a higher level of spiritual awareness, maybe you've never done these two things. So let's just check in and go, yeah, let me try that on. You know, if it doesn't work for you, it's all perfect. But actually what we're looking for is to have some sort of experience that previously we've not had. That would be a new, an awakening to something that potentially you've just not experienced. That for me is what I call experiential learning. So we can learn intellectually, which feeds the mind, but learning experientially is a whole different world. So the way to do this, next time you go out into nature, and if you're not going out into nature, I encourage you to go out into nature. Because what we tend to do, or what the mind does, is it deletes things, it distorts things, and it generalizes things. So I call it DDG. Distorts, deletes, and generalizes. And it does this for a sort of a reason, because there's so much information going on in the sort of the conscious world, so to speak, that to be able to take all that in is too much for us to be able to do. So we basically chunk it down and delete lots of things, we generalize things, and we distort things just so that they fit with our model of the world. So to go and test two things, firstly, just go out into nature. The woods are a great place to go. So maybe go for a walk in the woods. And then I want you to just pick a tree. Pick a tree that jumps out at you. I mean, not physically jumps out, but you know, just, you know, you're looking for a tree, one that feels like you connect to. Could be that it's a bit of an odd shape, or it's a bit of a loner tree, could be anything. But what you need to do is to, if you want to like have some fun and have a go at this becoming more aware, is to just stand near the tree, and then I want you to consider the tree in a way that you would might never have considered a tree. Now, different level, everybody's going to have their own experience of trees. Okay, the other day I was asking a question and I said to people, look, if there was a tree that was like you would could connect with, which tree would you choose? And I met a young lad who was in his early 20s who didn't even know the names of any trees. So that is his mind deleting trees. He sort of would look out at the big wide world and go, yeah, they're trees. But beyond that, no awareness of trees at all. Now, I'm not saying we need to get a tree dictionary and become an expert in trees. What we want to do is we want to look at the tree in a new way. So to become spiritually aware, what we need to do is to change our focus away from what we normally do. And that can activate this switch, this spiritual switch, which may have otherwise been either switched off or we didn't even know we've got it. Once we know we've got it, we can switch it on. So as we look at the tree, I want you to consider the tree in a way that you may never have considered a tree before. So one thing that's very interesting is that the tree and the human have got a lot in common. Now, we know that we've got blood. Cut ourselves, we've got blood. Now, a tree, technically speaking, has got blood as well. But it's actually not red. It's different. It's like the chlorophyll of a tree is very similar to human blood. Yeah. So I want you to just consider this tree for a moment and go, actually, this tree is alive right now in a similar way to which I'm alive. Now, sure, it hasn't got a brain, it hasn't got heart, lungs and the organs that we've got, but it is alive, okay? And it's alive in a way that we tend to just delete. So I want you to just connect with the tree and go, right, okay. So these roots, I'm standing on these roots. What are they doing? How do they work? How does this tree function? What's happening inside the trunk? What is the bark's job? And as maybe you look up at the branches and the leaves, and maybe, you know, if it's springtime or, you know, it's harvesting time, there'll be fruit on the tree of some description, yeah? Because all trees have a cycle, you know, a cycle of life, just like we have a cycle of life. So just I want you to just consider that cycle of life. What's going on in the fruit? Why is it doing that? How is it doing that? So it is alive in a way that we may never have really considered. Now that is just becoming more aware. And becoming aware, just as you do that, just start to feel that this thing we call a tree, it's just a label, is like me, it's alive. It's very, very alive. Right now, I'm standing next to something that, like me, is alive. It's just different to me, but it's very similar to me. And this is becoming what I call aware of something in the world outside of our normal world that is a living being as such that we don't normally connect with. Now, that might all sound crazy, but I encourage you to go and try it on. Yeah, and maybe, you know, below put some comments. So yeah, let me go and try that on and just see if I can connect with the tree and connect my life with the tree of the life. Yeah. Now the second one is to go out maybe into a field and just choose about a square meter of, like, might be grass. Let's just go. It's a field of grass. Now as we focus on this, like, square meter, I want you to consider what life is going on there. What life is going on in that square meter. Now, I can tell you that every blade of grass, like the tree, is very alive. It's very, very alive. It's not alive in the same way we're alive, because again, like, it's not a human, but it's got, each blade of grass is like a life. And living in that square meter will be unbelievable amounts of creatures. I mean, just the insect world that would live in one square meter of land is incredible. Now, these are all part of the ecosystem of the planet, and they're part of what we're part of. So we're all in it. David Cameron used to say, I think it was David Cameron used to say, we're all in this together. Which is true. Every blade of grass, every little creature that's living in that square meter is alive, it's got alive, and it's basically, we can connect with it, but we connect with it with our spiritual part of us. Okay, our mind, you know, we're going to use our mind, because look, we're all three. We've got all three of these things. It's not like we're turning one off in favor of another. We're getting, like, them to be in balance. And that's what I noticed about myself. I had a big mind, big body, little tiny spirit, spiritual awareness, yeah? And as I expanded my spiritual awareness, then I felt more in balance. So there's a much fantastic way of becoming more consciously aware of this part of you, which actually your mind is deleting, distorting, and generalizing about, yeah? So go and have some fun, either out in a field, looking at this square meter, maybe have a little dig around in the grass, but connect with it. Just connect with it and go, my God, the life that's going on planet Earth is phenomenal. And this activates this spiritual part of you, which otherwise is potentially just laying dormant. So that's it from me, Tony V from the 1010 Movement. I'll see you on the next video. Bye for now.